Next is for question number 13. This is the function given for you all, and you are asked to find to check whether it is a continuous function or not. So you have to check at the point 1. Okay, so here I'm writing left hand limit x tends to 1 minus f of x. So let x equal to 1 minus h. So limit h tends to 0, your function will be x plus 5. So limit h tends to 0, 1 minus h plus 5. So it is coming to be 6, left hand limit. For right hand limit, limit x tends to 1 plus f of x. So let x equals to 1 plus h. So limit h tends to 0, our function will be x minus 5. So limit h tends to 0, 1 plus h minus 5, so it is coming to be minus 4. And at x equal to 1, you have to consider the function, that is x plus 5, isn't it? So f of 1, it is coming to be 1 plus 5, that is 6. So left hand limit is 6, right hand limit is minus 4, and particular point is at 6. So therefore, we can conclude that fx is not a continuous function at x equals to 1. Okay, so you have to complete the answer in this way. Okay, now for question number 14, here your question is discuss the continuity. Okay, so if you see here, so there are how many points? 0, 1, 3, and 10. So there are 10 points. There are 4 points, isn't it? So at x equal to 10, you have to check at x equal to 1, at x equal to 3, and at x equal to 10. Okay, so here first we have to write at x equal to 0, so limit x tends to 0 minus, we have to write this function for left hand limit, isn't it? So it will be simply h tends to 0, so less than 0 means it is coming to be what, 3. Okay, similarly for right hand limit, so x cannot be greater than 1, so the right hand limit also the value is coming to be what, 3. And at particularly x equal to 0 also the value is coming to be 3. So here at all the point the function is continuous at x equals to 0. Okay, next we will check for 1. At x equal to 1, if you take left hand limit, that is 1 minus f of x, so if you take here h tends to 0, so here value less than 1 is which one, this one, so it is coming to be how much, 3. This is your left hand limit. And when you are writing right hand limit, so limit x tends to 1 plus, so if you see your function greater than 1 means 4. So here it is coming to be 4, and particularly at x equal to 1, your function where there is 1, that is equal to 3. So if you check here at 1 point, your values are all different, isn't it? So here this is continuous at x equal to 1, this is not continuous, isn't it? Now let us check for 3. So at x equal to 3, if you take left hand limit, limit x tends to 3 minus f of x. Now, for value less than 3, it is coming to be how much? Yes, limit h tends to 0, your value is less than 3, it is coming to be how much? 4. For right hand limit, so you will write limit x tends to 3 plus f of x, that is limit h tends to 0. So x value greater than 3 is coming to be how much? 5. That is value is coming to be 5. And at x equals to 3, so here you can see the equal sign is for the function 5, so f of x is coming to be 5. So here at x equal to 3 also all the 3 different value, so that means at x equal to 3 it is coming to be not equal, isn't it? Now let us check for x equals to 10. So left hand limit, so limit x tends to 10 minus f of x, so limit h tends to 0, less than 10, that is 5, greater than 10 also there is no any function, so right hand limit will also give us 5. And particularly at x equal to 10 also, at x equal to 10 also our function is coming to be 5. So here the function is continuous. That means at x equal to 0 and at x equal to 10 the function is continuous, but the function is discontinuous at x equal to 1 and x equal to 3. So whenever you are given more than 2 points or 3 points, so like this you have to check and do the continuity function. Okay, so question number 17, here I am, let us do one more question with continuity concept. But here you can see, you can see two variable A and B are given. So you are asked to find the relationship between A and B, where the point is to check at 3, and already the condition is given that at function is continuous at x equal to 3. So let us see. So already as per the question, it is given that at x equal to 3, left hand limit, right hand limit, and particular that value, all the values are equal to each other. So in place of left hand limit, we will write 3 minus f of x. That means limit h tends to 0. So less than 3 means what? Ax plus 1. So ax plus 1. So limit h tends to 0. So in place of x, we will write how much? 3 minus h plus 1. So it is 3a plus 1, that is your left hand limit value. Okay, similarly for right hand limit, you will write 3 plus f of x, that is limit h tends to 0. So x value greater than 3, that is bx plus 3. So you will write b 3 plus h plus 3. So here you will get 3b plus 3, and at f equal to 3, so where there is equal sign, that is ax. So here the function f of x will be ax plus 1. So f of 3 will be 3a plus 1. Okay, so now all the three values are equal to each other. So we are asked to compare it. So I will compare this two, that is 3b plus 3 equals to 3a plus 1. Or you can compare this two. So 3b minus 3a will be minus 2, or you can write 3a minus 3b will be equal to 2. That is 3, if you take 3 common. So if you see here, a minus b is equal to 2 by 3, or you can write a is equal to 2 by 3 plus b. So this is the relationship between a and b. So in this way we can use the concept of continuity and find the solution to every question of your answer.